Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we're going to be finding out what happens if you get inside the new Austin Devil's treehouse in Red Dead Redemption 2. So this is actually a mystery we covered a long time ago. I want to say like maybe 9 or 10 months ago. In case you guys don't know about this, there is actually a hidden treehouse that you can basically find near the McFarland Ranch in New Austin, and there is this mysterious creature up there. And if you approach the treehouse, this is what happens. Alright, so as you heard there, it was this shrieking, squealing man, and you find out that this guy is pretty much stuck up there, and you can actually end up shooting down the boards. He's like laying on top of them or something like that, and if you end up shooting them out, it's kind of like a game of Jenga. It's like how many boards do you have to shoot out before it'll fall, and he'll eventually plummet to the ground. And you can see what he looks like. And we'll even take a better look at him as this video goes on. And in that mystery, that experiment video that we tried a handful of months ago, I actually tried to save the guy that was stuck up there. And it turns out you could if you like put a cart underneath the treehouse. But he wouldn't have any extra lines of dialogue. In fact, John Marston, Arthur, whoever talks to this guy, doesn't have any lines of dialogue either. So I almost want to say that this was probably like a cut character that Rockstar had, or maybe even like a stranger that just never developed into a quest line that they just decided to throw sort of randomly into the game. And that's why we see him into the new Austin treehouse. And when Red Dead Redemption 2 was out on the consoles only, there's actually no way to get up into that treehouse. You can't climb the ladder. There's no way to get up there. So you basically just can only see what's going on from the ground. Well, now that the game is out on PC, this gives us the chance to explore really what's going on up there. So again, because you can't climb and stuff like that, I basically had to use a super jump mod in order to get on top of the treehouse. And then from there, I had to drop onto one of the branches so that I could then teleport on the inside of the treehouse. It was kind of an interesting process. It took me a couple of tries, but eventually I was able to get inside of the treehouse, and this is what this guy is doing. He's like playing a game of Twister up here. The dude is in like this Spider-Man wall climbing position, just sort of looking down at what's going on. And I don't know about you guys, but when I was younger, I loved building treehouses. I loved making them. I always thought that that was such a cool thing to do. And this guy didn't really design a good one. Like, there's nothing going on here. In fact, this thing is so small, basically the only thing you could do is like sleep in here. You could almost touch from one end to the other without having to move. So I will say, this guy kind of gets like a C+ in treehouse design. It also doesn't look very comfortable at all. But regardless, you can see what this guy is doing up here. He's, again, doing this like really weird game of Jenga and Twister. And again, basically the only way to get him down or to move is to end up shooting all the boards. And some of the boards won't even have an effect on him. As long as you like keep the main one up, this dude like won't fall over, which I do think is pretty funny. So this guy has some actually good balance up here. And then once you end up shooting down all of the boards, he obviously goes crashing all the way to the ground. But we obviously knew about that from the consoles. However, this gave me the opportunity to explore the rest of the house, or the tree house, I should say, to see what else is going on up here. And there's honestly not a lot. Like, I was able to get onto the porch area where there is a door that sort of keeps us from the inside. There is a bucket on a string or a rope, I should say. I guess that's how he ended up getting food or water. I don't know how this guy ended up getting down. But regardless, it was an interesting living situation nonetheless. Now, again, what's interesting about this guy is for the longest time, we didn't really have an ability to see who he was. But now that the game is out on PC, we can. So as you know, we can essentially change to any model that we want. And this model, A_M_M_Unicorpse_01, if we actually change our character into this, we actually get this like dead looking zombie guy. And what this character model is the base male character for like the dead or injured characters that you run across in game. And as we start to change some of their outfits, you can see that. They go from zombies to people with burnt corpses and arrows through them. We can even see some really creepy things like the dead Chelonians and even a like a Civil War soldier. But as we get to outfit 33, you can see that this is the new Austin Devil here. I don't know what this guy's official name is, but he's definitely got to be someone interesting because we can actually spawn in his character model here. So again, really, really cool stuff. Now, this does give us the opportunity to take a look more at this character. Now, you guys might need to correct me in the comments down below, but just sort of zooming in on his face, the first thing we can see here is a very distinct facial feature. It kind of looks like he has a cleft lip. I think that's the correct term there. That cleft lip is something that Gertrude Braithwaite has. If that name doesn't ring a bell, that's the lady stuck in the outhouse behind the Braithwaite Manor. And I don't know how she ended up developing the cleft lip. All I know is during this time, if you had this condition, many people believed that you were like an outcast or that you were cursed and that you weren't worthy of living with other people in society. And that kind of explains why Gertrude Braithwaite was locked away in the outhouse because her family was ashamed. And it might be why this guy has been relegated to this treehouse. Because if we take a look at some of the other stuff that he's wearing, it doesn't look like it's someone that's been roughing it up. I mean, if you look at his bottoms and his top, it looks like it was nice clothing, undergarments, and he's even wearing like Oxford boots. So this doesn't look like the kind of guy that just stumbled off in the middle of the woods. You know, what he's wearing is kind of nice. Obviously a little dirty since he's been living in a treehouse for the last couple of years, but still pretty nice nonetheless. Now what's interesting is there's not a lot of detail on this guy. Like for example, in the official Red Dead Redemption 2 strategy guide, the only thing that's mentioned about this guy's character is that you can find someone strange in a treehouse in New Austin. Like, he's not one of the strangers, he's not one of the chance encounters, and even on the Red Dead Wikipedia page, there's no entry for him. So this is honestly one of the most mysterious characters in the entire game, and that's also one of the reasons why I believe that this guy was supposed to have a bigger role in Red Dead Redemption 2. Because he seems so unique and he even has lines of dialogue, but there just doesn't seem to be anything to do with him. So I would imagine maybe there was a quest where we ended up getting him food, water, medicine, something like that. That might explain where there's a rope and a bucket that we would bring it up to him. Who really knows? There's a lot of things that we're just unsure about this guy in general. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. That is what happens if you get inside the New Austin Devil's Treehouse in-game. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. What do you think this guy was supposed to be like? Do you think he was supposed to have a bigger role in-game? Do you think this is just a fun little Easter egg? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you want to stay up to date on all the latest Red Dead Redemption and GTA videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.